understanding, saints, that Jesus, only Jesus, is the way. If you're in the fire today, don't know how you're going to get out of the fire. Understand that God said, never leave you nor forsake you. And when the 2 and 3 are gathered together in His name, He's in the midst. He's the only one that can put you out the fire. But I don't want you to praise Him when you get out the fire. I want to pray, want you to praise Him while you're in the fire. So when you praise Him while you're in the fire, the reward is even greater. Sometimes you have to thank God for the pain and the perseverance and the suffering. You see, God wants to make us and mold us and shape us into His people. We was made in His image, but many of us forgot that we're children of the Most High God. Many of us forgot what talents and what gifts we have. We are remarkable and phenomenal people. We have power. Jesus gave us power to go to the hospitals, to pray for the sick. We have that. Jehovah's Witnesses doing their thing. Muslims doing their thing. All these false doctors, they're doing their thing. And we're not doing nothing. They come in packs. They come in teams and trains. And this false religion, these comic books. We gotta pass this out. In the schools now, certain schools, if you say Jesus Christ, you can either get expelled or kicked out. Some people gotta end the prayer in different, they can't end the prayer in Jesus' name. They even trying to teach different curriculum. What's going on now is that they're having a one world religion, where they're gonna put all the religions together in one, and have our kids learn that curriculum. They're gonna start that in private schools and regular schools. My advice to the parents is please inform your kids at home. Let them know the difference. Because we cannot have our kids and people worshiping idol gods. The same gods they was worshiping in Daniel's day, the same gods they're trying to bring back now. And anything can be an image or idol. Jay-Z calls himself the God of rap. The God of rap. We have a different concept. Many people may say, you know, that's just a small thing. That's not a small thing. Because all it takes is that one thing to get you in the wrong direction. You may be in your car one day listening to Jay-Z. And he talking about Jesus can't save you. You may go over the clips on there. Turn that thing off. Put some gospel on there. Put something on there. That's dangerous. Have to try God. Trust God. Hold on to Him. I know it's like, you know, I feel like I had a bunch of people, now I feel like I got 5 people. Look at the other side, don't sit for me. Look at the other side, don't sit for me. You should start showing yourself. You don't know that up in heaven. Then I got that second death, that's a lake of fire. That's a body of fire, that's a lake. You're burning fire from brimstone. You want to be in heaven. You know, Peter said, save yourself from this wicked generation. You got to be ready. Jesus come back, you got to be ready. He don't come back as a twinkling of the eye. He going to come back that quick. He's going to blink. And if you miss, I'm going to be y'all. That's a tribulation time right there. They said people want to seek death, and death is going to flee. People want to jump off a building, jump from the cars, and can't die. You think I'm going to play down here? I don't care what you've done, please. Day and night, ask God, forgive me for my sin. I don't care what it is, if you forgot. Because sometimes we be sinning on what we sin. There's one of us there. We got to make it in. There's plenty of rooms. He said, let not your heart be troubled, for ye believe in God, also believe in me. Because in my Father's house there are many mansions. And one that saw, one that told you. And I go prepare a place for you. If I go prepare a place for you, I will come again to receive you in myself. He said, my Father's house there are many mansions. That means there's many rooms. We don't know how many mansions there's a lot. That might make sure that there's a room in that mansion. I don't care if I sleep on the floor. I'm here. In closing, Saints, beautiful hearts, I want y'all to understand and just listen. There's no other way. You can't stay now or later. You can't fall off once you're in the church. Stay in church. Don't come on Easter and Christmas and show up. Come every Sunday. You understand what I'm saying? If you don't come, please stay in your world. Say, well, you know, church is in my heart and I don't have church at home. A lot of people say that. I'm home watching Jerry Springer and Walker. We know it's a church. We know the body is a temple of the living God, but we have to feed our temple. We have to be heard. We have to let God move inside of us. Come into church. Because when you start going to church, you start hanging out with the wrong crowds. The wrong people. People you love that love you. Anybody can say, I love you. Don't tell me you love me. Show me love you. Anybody in church? I want the love of God. The love of Jesus Christ. Is there a greater love than that? Right. Yeah, if there's anybody, when the Pastor Son come up, that want to know how to get that love, or want to know who this Jesus is, that everyone's talking about. Because no matter where you're going, you can't escape it. Uh-huh. You can't escape it. The devil's real. Hell is real. He comes to steal, destroy, and kill. And Jesus said, I come so you may have life. And I have life. Thank you.